Once upon a time, the gods placed a sacred potion deep within the emptiness of the Baku Desert to be lost in time. One epic hero attempted to cross the barren wasteland in search of its secrets and powers. Legends say that if you drink the sacred potion, one would become impervious to being pranked. The chosen one, who was hand-picked by the gods of this sacred land, had to be both strong, mentally and physically. It had to be Elliot Giles. He traveled for hours, days without any food or water, no nutrients to maintain his godly physique. But he continued to stay on the path of righteousness. He felt a burning desire to prove to himself that he was the hero he needed to be. After what seemed like a lifetime of struggle, a shimmer of light in the distance brought some hope onto the face of our hero. He had done it. The people's champion envisioned his future and could almost taste it. But with one boisterous step, he slips. No! Ah! Ooh! Ah! Shit! He tumbles down the mountain like the sack of dung he is. Oh, Elliot, it seems you are not chosen. How disappointing. It's going to be one of their movies.
Said, Ben, can we buy it on digital copy? Can we buy it on DVD? Can we get hold of it? You don't need to buy it. You are watching it right now for free. If you want to watch it, hit the like button,
subscribe
button.
They get the point. They can watch the tour movie for free.
It's this video right now. Anyway, guys, we had to make Elliot think that he was dying. We said he had black tooth syndrome, and we had to get him to make a will.
I've had a letter from the doctors.
Saying what?
I'm dying, basically.
You're kidding me, right?
I wish I was, bro.
Do you want to come down to the office and have a chat about it?
Yeah, that would be good.
I'd rather talk to you than have a short-lived conversation.
Yeah, I'd rather talk about it.
Even if it is, I thought it was the first. Alright, bye, bro. Bye, man. Bye. Game time. First thing we gotta do is get Elliot to sign a will. That's a piece of paper that you sign that says, when I die, I'm going to give you, in Elliot's case, my £5 and my half bottle of beer. The point is, when you die and everyone else dies, they want to go out with a bang.
He's late.
Oh, do you think he's even going to buy into this?
Obviously, Carl, we said he left it.
Hello?
Hi, bro.
You're good?
What even is this?
Well, Elliot, the thing is, bro, when you're at this point in your life, it's important you get wills done and you divide your money and everything between people and...
Yeah, I know that. But why have I got to come here to do it?
I've got
basically, you want some of my money, didn't you?
No, I've got your...
Well, guess what? Screw you. You're getting none of it.
This is Jim Rogers, top solicitor. Help you. Jim, this is Elliot.
Nice to meet you, Jim.
Bro, this could actually put him in a coffin. This is... it's must. Just watch. Just watch.
Yeah, go on, you laugh!
Elliot,
I'm dying, you pricks!
Elliot wanted to take Nana on holiday.
Yeah, and you were my caravan! Bitch!
The only thing Elliot was going was off a cliff.
Shut up.
It's a nice caravan, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Look at the view and all.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's nice in, yeah?
It's cold though.
What am I going to eat, am I?
We'll go and get some.
I'm going to go down to the shop and buy some now, all right?
All right, Daddy, ready.
All right, you simple bitch. I'm going to the shop now. Why is there rocks underneath the wheels? Go on.
Now, you've always wanted to fly, you've always wanted to go to space, so I thought what better way to do it than to make a homemade cannon, turn Elliot into Evel Knievel,
and fill it full of fireworks and burn my pubes!
I'm sorry, bro! So to make Elliot fly through the sky, I had to get a cannon, then fill it with explosives, which were actually just some dodgy fireworks I bought off eBay, light the fireworks, run from the cannon, shouting sorry, bro, which to Elliot will probably die, but yeah. Sorry, bro. You look like a raging pervert! This is it, bro.
What the hell's you that? It looks like two bins put together.
What do you mean, Elliot? This
it looks like Nana's compost bin.
No, Elliot. Well, yes. But the point
I'm not getting in there.
We've got some sort of spring, explosive spring down the bottom that's going to shoot you out over to the edge. You're going to fly through the wind. You're going to be soaring. You're going to hit the soft grass.
Whoa, how am I supposed to even get in there, Ben?
Come here. Legs in. Legs in.
Is this even safe?
No. But let me just tell you, do not try this at home. Unless you know someone called Elliot Giles.
You ready, bro?
I'm ready.
Oh, help me! Stop standing there! Oh, I'm burning!
I've never had a tattoo myself, and I know tattoos are a thing, and that's one thing you really wanted.
Yeah! I really wanted a tattoo! Not on this, though!
Oh my god!
Why would I want that piece of shit? No! I wanted a lion! Roar! Because I'm a predator!
What?
Hello?
You alright, bro?
Yeah?
I've personally paid for you to have a tattoo.
Sure.
Bro, honest to God, you can have it all done. It's something for you to remember.
That's such short notice though.
Bro, you got short notes, you got short time left.
Yeah, I've always wanted a tattoo.
See you then. Bye, bro.
See you soon.
Yeah. How do we remove it when he finds out he's not actually dying?
I don't know, I don't care.
Good, bro. You good? How
are
you feeling this morning?
You want a lion on your back.
I want a lion on my back. How fierce does that look?
Well, you can certainly have a lion on your back.
Thank you, I think.
Hello.
I think this looks incredible, bro. I really think this looks insane.
Looks amazing. Yeah,
this is going to be amazing.
I'm scared.
Hey, it's Jeff, bro. Honestly, what are you doing?
Jesus Christ, this is worse than putting your hand up a constipated dog.
What? When have you ever done that?
Once in Tunisia. There's a dog called Barney. He was on the side of the dual carriageway and I had to help him out.
How long is this going to take?
A couple of hours, I think.
Fancy a cup of coffee?
Yeah, why not? Let's go.
So this is the tattoo removal place. Elliot's downstairs waiting. I'm gonna tell him that Nicola up here, who owns the place, is gonna remove the tattoo. She actually can't even do tattoo removal. Little does Elliot know, I have this. I'm gonna add super glue all the way up the bed and down the bed, so I don't know what's actually gonna happen. Carl might even remove the tattoo, but all I know, he's gonna go nuts.
Stop sniffing glue.
Alright, bro?
Surprise, surprise on the camera again.
Hey, we're recording the whole thing. This is the end of your life. What do you want to do?
Well, I don't want it to be on camera.
Besides, anyway, she's upstairs waiting. Your appointment's all go.
What? It's a hair salon.
Yes, efficiency. You know, hair salon, nail salon, tattoo remover salon, parlor.
Come on, let's get on with it. Put it this way.
Hi.
Oh, hi, Nicola.
Hi. Hi, Nicola.
Elliot's the one with the tattoo on his back that I explained to you.
Yeah, bit of a dodgy one.
No, it wasn't a dodgy one, it was a great one. Do you want to have a look?
There we go.
Is that good enough for you?
Can we remove it for a start?
Of course we can. We've
thank
done
God
many a tattoo removal and that would be nothing.
For free?
Amazing.
See?
Right, get out.
How long ago did you have this tattoo?
Yesterday.
Right, okay, so it's obviously just a little bit sore, yeah?
Yeah, it's still fresh.
Sorry about this, can we just answer this door 2 seconds? It won't be long.
Hello? Oh! Oh! Yeah, I did that yesterday. It's horrible, isn't it? So are you going to do anything or?
Ah! Ah!
Oh! Jeez, what the hell was that? Oh!
Doing is swiping right, swiping left on Tinder. You want to get married like anyone else.
Well, I didn't want to die alone.
Just roll the clip, Carl.
Carl, I'm scared. I'm not going to lie to you.
Why are you scared?
Why the hell am I here? This is where you put my wedding.
It's the best we can do.
Social club.
You give us £100 budget.
Yeah? I thought you would put at least some money. Where's Ben anyway?
He's late. Do you know he's like?
Oh, of course he's late. On the biggest day of my life, Ben, you decide to be late.
Well, you're fancying here, innit?
Not bad for the good, is it?
French fancy's my favourite.
I know.
What the hell are they doing here?
These are your grandparents.
Lovely vicar.
Nice to meet you. What's your name?
Steve.
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 Vicar Steve?
No, just Steve.
Nice to meet you.
That's what I was doing with coffee.
What are you wearing? This
I
is a wedding!
I didn't
have
this official, Elliot, did I?
Of course it's official!
I only met the girl!
Anyway, we are gathered here to join two beautiful people in love. Please welcome the bride. Does anyone see any legal impediment of why these two should not join in holy matrimony today? No? Great. Ah, shit.
What are you doing here?
It's not what it looks like.
I was with you last night.
Last night? I was with you on Tuesday.
What do you mean, last night?
Listen, go!
Don't say that to me now.
No, go!
You didn't say that last night.
Do it. Someone do something!
Oh my god!
Alright, so we finished? Is there anybody else? Now, again, is there anybody else?
Surprise, bitches!
What is that? What are you doing here?
You're marrying me, bitch! Come on! You can't marry me, bitch! Come on!
I'm not marrying you, bitch!
You're
disgusting!
I'm terrible!
What a disgusting boy! That's what I mean, you're not a woman!
I'm a woman!
Just piss off, you simple bitch! Right, you won't play that with her?
Skydiving. I can't skydive myself. I'm scared, but I thought...
Yeah! You put me in a paddling pool full of shit! And geese!
Yeah, I just got a skin disease from that as well.
Yeah, black toe.
This is something you want to do for a long time, Elliot, and we're making it happen. It's your bucket list.
Right. Wait, please pay the barrier. Okay. Beep, beep. Carl, just pay your ticket. Beep, beep.
What was that?
That was a train. That was a train. That was a train on bus. So the point is, bro, I know you both said you want to be free with the birds and you want to be one with the wind and, you know.
Right.
What the fuck is that called? This is supposed to be a skydiving.
That's
a budget ship. We're not a budget.
What are you talking about?
Nothing. Stop. What are you doing? Touching my boots.
Where are you?
What's wrong with you? Just look forward. We're trying to help you take this bucket list off, and I know this is important to you, Elliot. I know this is something special to you. You just got to... Watch your head, bro. Watch your head. The VR experience, bro. The VR.
Welcome
the skydiving.
What the hell's this shit?
VR skydiving, Elliot.
I want to go real skydiving. You guys have done it before.
Mate, welcome. This is a virtual reality skydive simulator. It's a great experience.
Bro, look at the famous people who have done this. You got Logan Paul, you got Tristan, Justin Bieber.
Honestly, lad, it's quite an experience. I'm addicted to it, me personally.
Are you excited for this? Come on, bro, this is what you wanted. It's on your back.
I wanted a real skydive!
You can chuck your suit on that I've got ready for you over here, and your goggles, and we're ready to go, and you'll have the time of your life.
I'm gonna pop out and get a coffee maybe, so if you wanna hang around with Elliot.
Yeah, okay, sure.
If I don't come out, Ben, I'm dead. Because this guy's staring me out like a weirdo.
Right, if you'd like to just step through this doorway here, mate. Oh yeah, that's better. And if you'd like to get underneath there,
Underneath where?
Well, if you bend down, you'll find out.
You should probably cut back on the pie.
Shut your mouth.
Try a stick of celery or something, mate. There you go, man. Perfect treat. That's perfect. So I'm just going to hook you in. And you have the time of your life, pal, all right?
I'm ready.
All right, let's get the hell out of here.
Hello, and welcome to VR Skydive. I am Iris, your personal VR companion. So please hold on tight and enjoy the flight. It is now time to experience true freefall. Please step over the bar in front of you. We are now approaching optimum altitude. You may experience some discomfort, but that is completely normal. Let go in 3, 2, 1.
Say.
Talking about digging for gold as well, he had a gold digger that day when we did the Lamborghini. Oh. You always wanted to drive.
She was so in with me. She wanted my dick. Oh. Where are we?
What? Look at that.
Yeah,
look at the rear bumper on that.
Yeah, for goodness sake.
Hey, how's it going? Supercar experience.
Yeah.
How can I help?
We booked in for the Lambo. Elliot Giles.
Elliot, just bear me a sec.
What's wrong with your chin?
Have
you been with us before? What are you doing? What are you doing,
idiot? I'm nervous.
Side effects because he's on his way
out. It's the Lamborghini you should be.
I'm a bit nervous.
Why? All you've got to do is control the speed.
Holy shit.
That's it, bro. That's what I'm saying to you, man.
Told you I'd get you a lap.
Come out.
Elliot.
Elliot, this is a 300,000 pound car. So don't break that or lose my life.
What do you mean your life?
I'm jumping in.
No, you're not. Hey, she's jumping in.
I'm the one who's rented it. Elliot. You're kidding me.
Oh my god.
And she's actually talking. This is what makes me sick about him, bro. I do everything for that guy, absolutely everything. Make him feel good for the day, do something nice. You know what, Elliot? Sorry, bro. Have you heard the saying, bros before hoes? Well, he's putting a hoe before a bro car. I'm stuck in this flipping matchbox of a car with you, and he's in a $5,000 Lamborghini there that I rent. No, don't woe me, bro. You can't shaft Phillips. You cannot shaft.
That's what's wrong.
That's not what I meant, bro. I got 10 mafia guys in the way. I got mafia cars. I got guns. I got the police coming.
How the hell have you got all this?
Remember Vicar Steve?
What?
Well, today, he's Mafia Steve. It wasn't even a real vicar, guys. It was just for the flipping church scene, you know, it's like...
Fancy a kiss?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Steve, go!
The Mafia! Oh my gosh, look at this! This is crazy!
What is going on?
Go!
Run!
Come on, that's not real.
No, it's fine.
Listen, they're guns upon
Toys R Us
or something.
No, shut up! Oh, God! Oh, God! He's batting!
Bro, they're going too far. Do you like that?
No, you just choked him and he broke his neck. How do I...
That's what it's about. Get him in the car, get it done.
First year of vicar, now you're a blooming mafia. What's that all about?
Whatever you need, Ben. Whatever you need, we can do it. All for the best.
Where's the girl, Steve?
She's in a book, didn't she?
Guns down, even local pub squad and everything.
She's
stupid. You're right.
She's all right. I'm not all right. I'm absolutely done with this. He stinks. Where's my money? I want my money.
Oh, you can't shut
the door. I can't believe it.
Shut the girl.
I'll have her. She's mine.
What's going on?
It's people who want to see you.
What's your name?
You want to have a little word?
Easy.
We pat it down?
Yeah.
So it's coming in. Go. Come on, boss, we got him. Gentlemen, sit down, be a good boy.
You don't know who you're messing with. My name is Elliot Robert Giles. I'm the mayor.
I should have you cut into pieces and fed to my pooches. But I like you. I've seen your YouTube videos, they're mildly amusing.
That's why you should let me off, I've done nothing wrong! Honestly!
We have a job for you to do. You do this, maybe I let you walk away.
What is this?
Take this case, deliver it to my cousins, and maybe we can come to another agreement.
I beg you, I will do anything. I took.
Take him home.
No! 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 No!
Go on, will you? Get it done.
Don't you be doing so much.
More!
Then that's it.
Listen.
Why is there a police car there?
It's not actually a police car, you dumb.
What do you mean there's not a police car?
He's not hired it.
How the hell did you hire a police car?
Because Steve. You know Bakery Dave? The guy who makes speed cupcakes, that guy.
Excuse me. Why have you got handcuffs to your suitcase, young man?
I've been abducted by the mafia.
Why have I got to get the police car? Oh my god.
What's happened, mate?
So basically, I had a supercar experience today. This Range Rover and all these different cars turned up, and then they took me out the car.
Oh, here comes the mafia.
That's them.
Get your hat on or something.
The police and the mafia are shaking hands.
What are you doing? No! Whoa! What are you doing? No!
So we're fully aware of what's going on, but...
What do you mean, sorry mate? I've done nothing wrong. Where are you going? Where are you taking me?
Well, I suppose you'll find out now, won't you?
No!
There he is!
Look at this!
Get off me!
No! Listen, I thought you were a man of God, but no, you're a man of Satan.
Yeah, that's right.
Get off me! Don't you dare, you prick!
Oh, Jesus Christ! Oh, God. Oh, baby. Oh, Jesus Christ, the window has gone.
Oh, no. Jesus.
Get on your knees.
You know what's coming. Wait. Shut up.
You know you've done wrong.
You know what you did. You're a scumbag.
You're chopping them up.
You don't mess with your daddy, Matthew.
You think that was good? Well, guess what? I'm giving away the opportunity for you, yes you, to become a cartoon in the next episode. All you gotta do is hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and comment below #BenandElliot.